Vivek, would you understand? Would you understand from here? Yes, the pollution which took place, many such world's freshwater bodies choked with phosphorus, that is near Madurai, that is in India. You are very much aware about the place Madurai, right? So eutrophication at Vaigai River in Madurai, which took place, you can see in the picture there what actually happened. That is because of those algal blooms grown over there, entire polluted place. Okay, algal bloom grown, all the organisms which are present dead because of the blocking of the sunlight. Okay, all the organisms dead because of the blocking of the sunlight, and because of which it resulted into such eutrophicated river. Okay, this is in India which happened. You can see in the picture there. Okay. So states and cities taking action, that is New Jersey, Maryland, Great Lakes, such everywhere in Portland, everywhere, it is the action has been taken. Okay, the action has been taken for so that there has to be no such problem occurring in future. Okay, there is no such problem has to occur in the future. One more is, one striking example is Tai Lake. You can see here. You can see a Tai Lake in China. It is because combined with the sewage and industrial discharge led to a massive toxic blue-green algae bloom in May 2007. So what had happened is because of the sewage and the industrial discharge into the river, into that lake, Tai Lake, led to the massive toxic blue-green algae. Blue-green algae is nothing but cyanobacteria. Blue-green algae are nothing but photosynthetic bacteria. Okay, it is also known as cyanobacteria. Okay, those algae bloom in the May 2007. The bloom rendered the water in the lake too polluted for human agriculture and industrial uses, and residents were forced to import water from the other locations. So see, the disadvantages or the consequences are so bad, they had to import water from the other location. So these are the some of the examples of eutrophication in India. If you find it out, like Noor have also given the example of Mexico, that's a dead zone. Then about the Britannica, Kirti had given, that is also one of the place which have been a part of a eutrophication, because the river, there were much of a eutrophication taken place because of the large number of large number of industrial waste were allowed to move into it. Okay, so very good students, you just went through it and got the information. I'm very happy about this. And please do keep searching about such things so that you are kept updated that how and what is happening, because of pollution. Okay, very good. I'm very happy regarding this. Okay, let's move on to the next topic. Okay. Okay, before moving to the next topic, we will just know about eutrophication, about that two types, because yesterday also some, I guess, Dikshita. Okay, before that, before I go move into the next, I want everyone to just have a clear picture about what eutrophication does. You can also draw it for your better understanding. Okay, you can also draw it for your better understanding. Understanding. And if you are taking a screenshot, please make sure that you go through it once again. Don't just keep it in your mobile gallery. Okay. So this is about what happens actually in the eutrophication. This is how the steps takes place. 1, 2, 3, 4. The numbers are input. It's for your better understanding. Okay. Nutrient load up. Then plant flourish. Plant flourishing take place. That is the sedge grass. You remember yesterday. The sedge grasses were grown here. This area. Then what happens? Nutrients, nutrient loading up takes place. Then later decomposition further depletes oxygen. Here decomposition takes place. The decomposers takes the oxygen. Okay, algal blooms and oxygen is depleted. Algal blooms grow on the surface and death of the ecosystem. death of the ecosystem is nothing but oxygen levels reach a point where there is no life possible in this water. Finally, what happens? All the sedimentation takes place and it becomes a total land. Okay, as Aaron said, there must be many such ponds near your houses as well, which has undergone eutrophication. Okay, with time or with centuries, with decades. Okay, understood, right? Please have a kind of a flow chart in your mind. What happens in eutrophication? Okay, clear about this? Anyone has a doubt regarding eutrophication? These are the point wise. Please do keep it. Yes. Please do just mark it and keep. Everyone must be answering. Okay. Everyone must be answering. Today, Swarup Sangeeta is not there in the class. As I said yesterday, I know many of you, all of you, almost of you. Okay, so coming to eutrophication, again, there are two types, natural and cultural. Remember this, there are two types, natural eutrophication and cultural eutrophication. In natural, by streams, what happens is in natural, there is nothing. I guess yesterday Deekshita has asked me about tell about natural and cultural. If there are any doubts, please do put it down. Everyone's doubts will be clarified. Okay. So natural and cultural. Natural by streams draining into the lake, increase nutrient like nitrogen and phosphorus. So you remember, just in the start, I just told about, okay, differences I'll tell you. So in the natural, what happens? First thing you have to remember is in natural, whatever nitrogen, the phosphorus, which comes into this water will be from the soil. Okay, will be from the soil or from the any other sources. Okay, from the natural sources it will be. Okay, like nitrogen, phosphorus, it can be from the manures. Okay. It can be from the manures or it can be from the fertilizers. They will come and deposit over here. Okay, those natural phosphorus and the nitrogen will come and deposit over here. Okay, will come and deposit over here. But the other thing is, it will take. Yeah, I'll play the video. Okay, so what happens is, first let me clarify the doubts about natural and cultural eutrophication. What happens? Okay, so what happens here? Okay, so what happens here? The nitrogen and the phosphorus will come here from the soil. Okay, from the fertilizers which we use and all, from there it will come. Okay, so what happens? It takes longer time for the sedimentation. Okay, because that will be not in huge in number. That nitrogen, phosphorus, which will come from the flowing water, from the rain water, from the river water, will take a longer time for sedimentation. Okay, it will take a longer time for sedimentation, and it is temperature dependent also. This eutrophication is natural type of eutrophication is temperature dependent also. So what happens only if from the rain water, from the river water, if this nitrogen and phosphorus comes and they settle down here, okay, and they settle down here, the eutrophication occurs. This type of natural type of eutrophication occurs. Okay, when the nitrogen and phosphorus from the water, okay, when the nitrogen and phosphorus from the rain waters, from the river waters will come and settle down here, okay, the nitrogen content will, the nutrient content will increase in this water. Okay, the nutrient content will increase in the water, which will lead to the eutrophication. Okay, which will lead to the eutrophication. You can see the difference here. Earlier, the fish you can see here, duck you can see here, some plants you can see here. Later, what has happened is the sediment is very less amount over here. But later, what happens as the eutrophication takes place, the sediment has gone till here. Okay, the sediment has gone till here means the nutrient has increased. Okay, and you can see a little amount of water present. Yes or no? A little amount of water present. Whereas here you can see a more amount of water present. Okay, Dikshita, can you understand the difference, right? Here a more amount of water is present, whereas very little amount of water is present here and more of a sediment. Okay, more of a sediment. So this is nothing but natural eutrophication, and the time taken is centuries. Okay, long time is taken. Long time is taken. It's not a very rapid process. Okay, natural eutrophication is not a rapid process. Now remember the points. Okay, put down it as a points. Okay, either write it down or either remember this as a points. So what happens in natural eutrophication is natural eutrophication. What happens by the natural process? Such nitrogen, phosphorus will come from the streams, from the rainwater. Those from the streams, from the rainwater, which are washed down to such rivers. Okay, which are washed down to such rivers, increase the nutrient content. Okay, increase the nutrient content into the water. Increase the nutrient content into the water, and natural eutrophication is a slow process. Okay, natural eutrophication is a slow process. It takes a longer time. Okay, natural eutrophication is slow process. And one more thing is, it is also temperature plays a very important role here. Okay, the temperature, the change in the temperature also plays a very important role in natural eutrophication. You have to remember these three points. Okay, clear about natural eutrophication? You have to only remember about this three points. Whereas in cultural eutrophication, okay, remember this. In cultural eutrophication, what happens is, in cultural eutrophication, the pollutant by the man activity, industries and homes can radically accelerate the aging process. Now, what happens here? In cultural eutrophication, imagine now this pond is near your house. Okay. And for a very long time, this pond is there. When you were very small, from very tender age, you are seeing this pond. Okay, there are fishes. Okay, there are fishes. Then there is a duck over here. Everything is normal going on. But a natural eutrophication must have been taking place here as well. Okay, by the rainwater, by the river water, some amount of fertilizers have come here and the sedimentation have taken place. Okay. Now what happens after some time? Okay, after some time you see one industry has put up, set up here, buildings have come up, houses have come up. Okay, now what happens? The earlier which natural eutrophication has taken and this much of sediment was there, what has happened is the industrial waste, the house waste, the sewage from these buildings, everywhere, everything has come into this river. Okay, everything has come into this river or this small pond. Now what has happened? The sedimentation has rapidly started happening. Okay, rapidly started happening. Okay, rapidly started happening is because of much amount of waste is coming here. Much amount of waste is coming here, and the nutrient concentration is increasing. Okay, increased amount of sediment is waste is coming here, and the nutrient is increasing. Nutrient concentration is increasing. Okay, and that takes a very less time. That is, decades are there centuries, and over here decades is because of radically accelerate the aging process. Radically means very fast. The acceleration means the process is very fast. Okay, within decades time, you can't see that particular pond there present because of lot of waste dumped in it. Okay, because of lot of waste dumped in it, and you can only find a piece of a land over there after some time. You have seen in the picture, right, where in Madurai, how it has happened now, all everywhere the algal bloom has grown, and because of which you do not find the water. Okay, and the all organism has been totally vanished away from there because of no proper oxygen, sunlight, and even no proper pure water as well to survive. Okay, It is nothing but if you take a beaker and a water and you are putting if you are putting thing, you are taking one beaker and water, and every day you are putting one a teaspoon of, what is that, salt in it. Okay, a sugar in it. Now you are filling it every day, so that every day 1 teaspoon. What happens is it takes a bit time to come. It gets dissolved. Okay, it gets dissolved, or it takes a little bit of more time to fill or to come up to that proper beaker. But if once only you put an entire packet, okay, entire packet of a salt into it, it will fill up to half of that. It will fill up to half of that beaker. Yes or no? It will fill up to half of that beaker. The same thing we do here. The same thing we do here. Larger amount of waste is allowed to come into it, because the industries work daily. Every day they will have some waste which will be thrown into this, or which will be sent into this water. The sewage, every day there will be some of the other sewage waste which will be allowed to come and sediment over here and from the household as well. And because of which, the process is faster, and it only takes a time of decade for entirely covering that water body. Okay, cultural eutrophication takes place from the waste of industries. The nutrient increase of the nutrient amount takes place because of all the industrial waste allowed to come into this particular water body. Okay, aging process is fast. Aging process is fast in a sense. Eutrophication process is fast. Okay, the difference between natural and the cultural is the same. Natural is from the waste from the soil. Such as nitrogen and phosphorus, such nutrients come and settle down, and they slowly, gradually, the eutrophication takes place. Whereas in cultural eutrophication, the eutrophication is faster. When you had seen that in the earlier, where the phosphorus eutrophication had taken place, yes or no? In Madurai. Here you can see here in Madurai, your phosphorus body is choked with phosphorus because large amount of phosphorus was allowed to move into it from some industries. From some industry, if you find it there, you will get to know more about how and when, how easily they just allowed the phosphorus to go into this particular river, and because of which the eutrophication has taken place, and it is totally, the river has eutrophicated, like it is, you cannot find the water there at all. Okay, so this is kind of a cultural eutrophication. Okay, this is kind of a cultural eutrophication. Okay, clear about this? Anyone has got any doubt regarding it? Cultural and natural? Okay. So cultural is entirely dependent on all the waste from the man activities. Okay, whereas natural is from the soil, from such washed away fertilizers. Okay, from by the water, natural eutrophication takes place. Okay, natural eutrophication takes time, whereas cultural eutrophication is faster. Okay, clear to everyone? What is the doubt, Harish? Is there any doubt regarding this? Tell me, is there any doubt, Harish? What doubt? Okay, is there any doubt or no doubt? You don't have any doubt, okay. Okay, very good. Everyone must be answering here. I want everyone should be answering. Next time I will ask everyone's name, and I'll ask you. Okay, now coming to thermal pollution. How many of you are aware about the thermal pollution happening? Okay, tell me, anyone knows that what are the consequences of thermal plants set up? Tell me if anyone knows. Just if anyone knows. Thermal plants set up anywhere. causes air pollution. Okay, there is one more reason also causes air pollution. Is there any thermal plant in Karnataka? Yes, causes air pollution. Very good. Okay, Aryan Villa factory. Okay. It's okay. Factory is there. Thermal plants, power plants will be like one of the major reasons. Okay, one of the major reasons for the air pollution as well as the water pollution, and that in together called as thermal pollution. Okay, very good, Aryan. Okay, we'll let us know more about it later. Okay, so. Yes, thermoplow. I'll let you know. Okay. So, first thing is, let us know what is thermal pollution. Cause many health problems. Yes, Shaktinagar thermal power plant. Okay. Very good. So here, what thermal pollution is? We'll know first. Thermal pollution is nothing but which is. Effect of plants and animals power pollution. Very good. Okay, so thermal pollution is nothing but which the pollution is done from these thermal plants. Okay, from these thermal plants which is happening, which leave out the waste. Okay, the waste, and also it causes also the air pollution. Okay, it causes also the air pollution. Causes. So warming up of an aquatic ecosystem to the point where its desirable organisms are affected. I had told you in the initial, in the start only. So what happens here is, warming up of that ecosystem takes place. Yes, body parts. Yes, correct. It causes, we will know more about the effects of the thermal pollution. Okay, very good. So warming up of an aquatic ecosystem to the point where desirable organisms are affected. No problem, Ranjita. Don't worry. Okay, so example is the thermal power plants. From thermal power plants, what they do is they leave out the waste into the water bodies. Okay, into the water bodies, and what happens is warming up of such water bodies takes place. Okay, warming up of such water bodies takes place. So what happens here, you can see there are some labeling has been done here, so we'll know about it. So you have to only remember. Yes, good, Clara. So you have to only remember thermal pollution, warming up of an aquatic ecosystem to the point where desirable organisms are affected. So the desirable organisms are nothing but the fishes, the other organism, beneficial organisms, okay, present in the water are being affected. So what happens here is these thermal plants leave out the waste. Okay. It will be of high temperature as well. Hot waters have been left into the water. Okay, hot waste waters are left into the water. Harmful chemicals are left into the water with a high temperature as well. It will be of high temperatures which are left into the water. What happens is suffocation of the fish takes place. Suffocation is nothing but where they can't breathe, move. Okay, where they can't breathe, move, or reproduce as well. Okay, suffocation takes place. Altered food web. Okay, the fishes cannot get the small fishes cannot get the algae in the water. Okay, the small fishes cannot get algae in the water because of which they die. Then later what happens is the small fish, the larger fish do not get small fishes to eat. Okay. If there is any doubts, please put down in the chat box, Vaishnavi. So what happens is the larger fish do not get the small fishes because the small fishes cannot eat the algae and all because which are dead because of such waste which are allowed to go into the water. That affects the food web. Okay, it affects the food web. Yes, it breaks the food chain. Okay, it breaks the food chain. Later, what happens is decreased fish population. Yes, later at one point of time when the smaller fish do not get algae and the larger fish do not get small fish, they die. Okay, they die. Then what happens is low dissolved oxygen. The oxygen content decreases. Okay, the oxygen content decreases, and because of which total destruction of the aquatic life in the water takes place. Okay, total destruction of the aquatic life takes place. So here, what happens due to thermal pollution is suffocation of the fish, because of which also they can die. The algae, the zooplanktons, the phytoplanktons, which are present, which are not toxic, which are used as a food by such fishes, they are also depleted from there. The small fishes die, because of which the large fishes die. Okay, and it alters the food web. Decreased fish population takes place and low dissolved oxygen. So thermal pollution affects so much on this water, the aquatic life, because they leave such thermal waste into the water bodies. Okay, they leave such thermal waste into the water bodies. Okay, so warming up of an aquatic ecosystem. Aquatic ecosystem is nothing but the water in that water bodies which are present from the zooplankton to the larger organisms, okay, to the larger fishes, okay, to point where desirable organisms are affected. All the organisms which are present in the water are affected because of the thermal pollution. Okay, because of the thermal pollution. Other effects which everyone has said, yes, very very good. Breaks the food chain, yes, Aaron, very good. Then effects on the plants and animals, yes. If this water is being taken up by the other organism, Ananya, if there is any doubts, please put down in the chat box. Okay, so it affects the plants and animals. Then it causes effects on the body parts as well, because it affects your body as well. Then causes many health problems, yes. And these are the some of the effects. Okay, it affects on the, Ananya, please put down if you have any doubts, please put down in the chat box. Okay, so it affects your health as well, okay, and disrupts the whole entire ecosystem. Okay, disrupts the entire ecosystem. Ananya, if you have any doubt, please put down in the chat box. Anyone who is raising hand, please put down the doubts in your chat box if there is any question. Enhance the growth of the plants. Okay, if we go through eutrophication, what happens, you know, Vani? The nutrition enrichment takes place, whereas from thermal plants. Okay, Ananya, no problem. Okay, but in the thermal plants, what happens is the whatever they sent out from the thermal plants will be high temperature. Okay, high temperature waste they will be leaving out in the water, because of which the temperature increases in the water. Okay, in these rivers, warming up takes place. Okay, warming up takes place. The warming up of the water bodies takes place. Okay, because of which this suffocation of fish, alteration of food web, decrease in fish pollution and population, and low dissolved oxygen will be affecting the water body. You understood, Navani? Enhancing the growth of plants means it enhances the growth of plants in eutrophication, where what happens, nutrient content increases. Okay, nutrient content increases, whereas in thermal pollution, what happens is the warming up of the river, the water bodies takes place. Okay, as the warming up takes place, it affects the organism which is present in the water. Okay, Ananya, hopefully, if there is any doubt, it's clear. Okay, Vani, you understood, right? What happens in thermal pollution? thermal pollution, what happens is when they leave out the temperature based waste into the water bodies, it affects the food web. It even affects the iceberg areas, I guess. If you have known about how it affects the icebergs and how much of the icebergs have been totally depleted out because of such warming, from the thermal pollution or from the global warming as well, it is quite a large number. Earlier, the icebergs were in much number, whereas now it has been affected in a larger number, because of which the water level is also increasing. Very good, Clara. It affects the iceberg as well, because of the heating up or the warming up of the water bodies leads to the melting up of such icebergs as well. Okay, which is also a part of a global warming. If anyone knows about the BBC video gallery, which they have given out a video in 2020 odd day, you must have seen how much it has affected the icebergs as well. I would recommend you people to see such things, okay, so that it will only enhance your knowledge. Very good, Clara. I'm very happy you said this about the icebergs as well. So Ranjita had asked me, NGO as well. Very good. And BBC, this two BBC video gallery, something which gives you more about information about the Earth. Okay, someone had asked me this, Ranjita. I want you to just see it. I guess we are running out of time. Okay, if there are any doubts, please do ask me in the next class. Please go through all the points. Note down the points. No other notes will be provided. Please note down the points.